This is Kristen Morato from Belgium.
Do you want to make cupcakes with me?
Yes, let's do it. Gotcha.
Okay, can someone hand her a cupcake and the icing
from
tray?
Belgium. From your left.
I'm going to go for this.
Okay, I've never even done
and
this
look,
before.
Look how pretty this looks with your lipstick, though.
Come on. Like, and now
like,
it's
I
coming
did
like...
my lips with icing bags.
I've never done this before.
So what's up, Kristen?
I've been good. I mean, yeah.
Tell me about it.
In New York.
Okay.
Not a bad thing, not a bad city to be at.
Where do you live normally?
I live in Los Angeles.
You do? I'm from Los Angeles.
In Hollywood.
That's cool. I'm from Los Angeles, but my character, Emily Nelson, in this film, is a, she's not originally from New York City, but she's a bit of a New York City girl who moves to the suburbs.
You know, I hear she's quite the character.
She's quite the character. What's interesting, you know, I think this is actually really fascinating, is that when you're young, you're celebrated for the daring, bold things that you do. And oh, that's actually really cute.
I'm done with this one. I'm going to need
great.
Another one.
I know, right? You got to decorate the base, too. Come on, you can fill that in.
Oh, with sprinkles?
Yeah. No, but when you're young, you're celebrated for all the things that you do that are wild and adventurous and outlandish. And then once you get married and you have kids and you're meant to be a mother or a wife or a husband and you move to the suburbs, suddenly all the things that you did that were really daring and racy are no longer celebrated.
Yep.
And that's such a strange thing that you suddenly have to like shift who you were because your audience is different. Like, when do we all decide that? And so that's what I think is neat, is that like everybody in the suburbs, you know, had a youth and maybe had a rebellious stage or has history or, you know, things that they may be proud of or not, that they're not talking about. And that's why I think it's so cool that this movie takes place in the daytime, is that there's, you know, there's so much darkness and so much suspense and mystery that happens, but it's all in just another day in the suburbs.
I really love the movie. I still have to see a movie where you weren't good in, but for this movie,
nice of you to say.
What I heard is that you had 11 pages of dialogue, some scenes. Like, how did you how did you pull that off?
Well, it was not only 11 pages of dialogue, but it's 11 pages of dialogue for Paul Feig with Anna Kendrick, which is just incredibly intimidating because they're two of the best in their field. And I've never done a comedy before, but I was so excited and so ready. So I, you know, said earlier, it felt like I was getting to, you know, play tennis for the first time at Wimbledon, you know, and with Serena Williams. Like, it was just really, it was just the greatest experience, and just so thrilling and such a rush of adrenaline to get to do this type of movie with them. And so much of the movie was improv, too. So Paul gave us such freedom, and I really appreciated that he respected us and valued us enough to let us just go and play.
And I think that the improv, that's something that is, as an actress, has got to be really great. Especially,
so much fun.
Yeah.
Well, you know, it gives you such opportunity to be alive in the moment and to really like respond to what's happening and to listen to every instinct or every thought you have. And that's, you know, it's neat.
Well, they're giving me the wrap.
Are they already?
Yes. I made too many cupcakes, so.
Let me see. Those look pretty good.
I made a mess. My goodness, you made like a flower. I made a.
Well, I'm just trying to do a little rosette. That's all. Just a French peony, but
you've done this before.
Do you want a martini before you go?
Sure. I'm not gonna say no.
Come on, let's do this. Some Aviation American Gin. Cheers to Syracuse. We can honor both of our husbands right here.
Yep, and he's also Asian, by the way.
Is he?
Oh
my gosh.
He's Chinese.
Watch out, Henry Golding. Yeah. Okay, right. Cheers.
Cheers.
Mine's already gone.
Cool.
Woo! It's okay, she's so drunk, you guys.
I'm like,
take her out.
So many times.
We're gonna have people like carrying
God,
you out of here.
All over my face.